Assalamu alaikum students, how is you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel Maths E1D to Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to chapter 12 and I am going to explain you exercise 12B. Okay students, before starting the lecture, I will request you that if you want more help regarding your subject, then you can subscribe to the channel. Your book is New Syllabus Mathematics to D2 Math. Alright, so now question number 1 is find the volume of each of the following cones. Okay students, remember that the cones are given. So you can find out the volume of the cone by using the formula, and that is volume of the cone is equal to 1 by 3 multiplied by base area multiplied by height. So just remember that in cone the base area is a circle, because as you can see that if this is a cone, then this base area is the circle. Okay, this is the base area, and the formula to find, you know that this is a circle, so to find out the area of the circle is, the area of circle is, we know that that is pi r square. So base area is pi r square, because in every cone the base area is a circle, and the formula to find out the area of the circle is pi r square. So base area is pi r square. So now here we are going to use this formula to find out the base area. Okay, now let's put the values to get the volume of the cone. Okay, in part A you can see that we have to find out the volume of the cone. So I will write 1 by 3 as it is, and the base area is pi r square and multiply by height. Now I am going to put the values 1 by 3. So here you can see that at the base the radius is, you know that this is a circle. So this midpoint, any line from midpoint to the edge of the circle is called radius. This is the radius, and the diameter is a line which touches one end to the other end. This full line is the diameter, and the half line from the midpoint is the radius. So radius is given, which is 6 cm, and height of the cone is given, which is 14 cm. So I am going to put the values 1 by 3 multiplied by, you know that the value of pi is 3.14159. Okay, the value of pi is, okay, I am going to find out the value of pi so that I can write correctly. Okay, gee, I can write down 3.14159. Okay, gee, r square is the radius. Radius is given, which is 6. So it is 6 square multiplied by height. So I'll write 1 by 3 as it is. 6 are 36. I'll multiply 36 with the value of pi. 6 multiplied by 6 are 36. So when I'll multiply it, I will get 113.14. Multiply by height. Now I'm going to divide this with 3. So I will get, okay, height is also given, which is 14. Okay, now I'm going to multiply 113.14 with 14. 113.14 with 14. So I will get 1583.96, and I will divide it with 3. When I will divide it with 3, I will get 527.9. Okay students, I can round up this number, so I will get 528 cm³. So this is the cube of part A, okay, volume of the cone. This is the volume, okay, this is the volume of the cone which we have found in part A, and I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's come to B part. Okay, so B part is, here the height is given, which is 5, all right, and the area of the base is given, 154 cm². So here we have to find out the volume. So first I will write down the formula. Volume of the cone is 1 by 3 multiplied by base area multiplied by height. Okay, so I will write down this volume as it is. I will write down 1 by 3 as it is. Now area is given, which is 154. In this question students, the area is given, so we are not supposed to find out the area. And height is also given, which is 5. Okay, so now I am going to multiply 154 with 5 and I will divide it with 3. So 154 multiplied by 5 will be equal to 770. When I will divide it with 3, I will get 256.67. Okay, students, here yes, 256.67. You can write down the number in mixed, you can write down the answer in mixed number and you can write down the answer in decimal number. Both forms are right. Okay, in your book, maybe the answer is given in the mixed number. So you can write down the answer in mixed number. So your answer would be 256, 2 over 3 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of the cone in part B. This was part B. Okay, students, now I'm going to explain you part C and I hope that you are clear. Okay, students, part C is, okay, in part C, the height is given, which is 14 centimeter, and the radius is, and the diameter is given, which is 7 centimeter. Students, as I have told you that in the circle, the line which joins one end to the other end, that is the diameter. This is the diameter. And the radius is from the midpoint to the edge. So, it means that radius is half of the diameter. So, in this part, first we'll find out the diameter, so we can, then we can find, further find out the volume of the cone. Okay, remember that radius is the half of the diameter. So in part C, first we'll find out the radius. So radius is equal to d over 2. And so radius is equal to diameter is 7 over 2. So I will get 2 3s are 6 and 2 5s are 10. 3.5 centimeter. Okay, this is the radius. Now I'm going to find out the volume. Volume of the cone I will write as it is. 1 over 3. As you know that base area is the formula. Base area is basically you have to find out the area of the circle. Then the formula to find out the area of the circle is pi r square multiplied by height. Height is given, which is 14. Okay. So now I'm going to write down the value of pi, which is 3.14159. And the radius is given, which is 3.5. And multiply by 14. Now you have to solve it. Okay, so you will multiply here 3.5 square is 12.25 and you have to multiply 12.25 with 14 and then with the pi, which is 3.14159. Okay, so what you will get? You will get 538.7826 and you have to divide it with 3. When you'll divide it with 3, you will get 179.59. Okay, students, now here you can round off the number. So you will get, you can round off this number 179.59 or 180. You can round off this number, so you will get 180 centimeter cube. So this is the volume of the cone in part C. And I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's come to D part. Okay, students, in D parts, now here the circumference is given. Circumference is given and height is given. Height is 28 millimeter. And circumference is given, which is 132 millimeter. So, students, the formula to find out the circumference of the circle is of circle is 2 pi r. Now, here in this case, the circumference is given. Why we are writing down the formula of the circumference of circle? Because to find out the volume, we need R. So we can find out R through this. Okay. So 2 pi means 2 multiplied by 3.14159. And I will write R as it because we have to find out the R as it is. Okay. Now you have to multiply 2 with 3.14159. Okay, when I will multiply 2 with 3.14159, I will get 6.28318 radius. Now I have to divide this with 132. This is multiplying with that. If we come to this side, it will divide. So 6.28318 is equal to R. So when I will divide it, 132 with answer, so I will get 21.
So radius is 21 millimeter. Now we have found the radius. Now we can easily find out the volume of the cone. Okay, here I am going to find out the volume of the cone. Volume is 1 over 3 multiplied by base area. So base area is pi r square multiplied by height. So height is 28. Pi is 3.14159 multiplied by r. R is 21. So I will take the square of 21 and I will multiply it with 28. Now I will solve it. 21 square is 441 multiplied by 28 multiplied by 3.14159. So I will get 38792.35332. And when I will divide it with 3, I will get 12,930. And when we will round it off, we will get 12,900 millimeter cube. So this is the volume of the cone in part D. Okay, so I hope that today's lecture is clear to you. Take very good care of yourself. Thank you very much, and Allah Hafiz.